Who knows this guy? Anyone? I know all the old smart Greeks look the same. Well, it's Aristotle, an early science slammer. And if he was around still, he would probably publish at ICWSM, because a lot of the wisdom that he dropped on humanity had to do with social problems. He wanted to design the optimal society, and he was also the one to call humans the zoon politikon. The man is a social animal. But if you think about it, a lot of animals are social. Think of bonobos, or this lovely, heartwarming story about penguins told by Morgan Freeman, or just something as banal as ants or bees. But there's one social skill that no animals except us humans have, and that's a sense of humor. Maybe not myself, because I'm German, but... If you've ever eaten yourself into cheese delirium, you might have seen a laughing cow, but chances are it wasn't real. And so since humor is such a uniquely human trait, understanding humor is really crucial to understanding humans. And guess what? Old Grandpa Aristotle knew that too, and that's why he called humans not only social animals, but also laughing animals. So it seems he really got a kick out of calling humans animal names. Okay, so despite what you might think now, this talk is not about Aristotle. It's actually about the digital divide. Does that qualify me for the special prize? No, obviously this talk is about cats. No, what this talk is really about is about a project on computational... computational humor that got started last summer during an internship with Eric Horvitz at Microsoft Research. So Eric and I... I see this cat like jiggling around in front of me. Okay, so Eric and I wanted to look at humor in a data-driven fashion. So data is humor, if you will, anyone who gets that. but the question was, what data to use? And there are a lot of, some fairly large joke corpora out there, but the problem with many jokes is that they have this sophisticated narrative structure. So there's this slow build-up of context, and then bang, the punchline turns everything upside down. So we wanted to do without that complexity while still getting at some of the core aspects of humor. So what we wanted is something like one-liners, where there's no... none of this narrative structure. So enter The Onion. Who in here has read The Onion before? All right, cool. So for those of you that haven't, The Onion is a satirical newspaper that publishes stories that on the surface look quite like real news, but once you look at them a bit more closely, you realize that they're actually quite absurd. Stuff like black man given nation's worst job when Obama was elected president, or Bush urges nation to be quiet for a minute while he tries to think when Bush was still president, or something like drugs win drug war. You saw that the punchlines alone made you laugh. You didn't even have to read any of the proper article. So here we have it. Here we have our perfect one-liners, punchlines only, no narrative structure, exactly what we want. All right, so The Onion is considered by many the pinnacle of contemporary English satire, so generating that kind of stuff automatically would really be something like the Holy Grail. Obviously, spoiler, we're far from there, but I like to call this project Clockwork Onion, but we're far from there. So let's start simple. One of the early striking observations is that a lot of the funniness of these headlines comes from the fact that they're so similar to real news headlines. Look at this example. Mississippi bans soft drinks smaller than 20 ounces. published by the Onion, and nearly identical to the headline, sugary drinks over 16 ounces banned in New York City, which is a real news headline from CBS News. So given the similarity of serious and satirical here, this opens up the opportunity to do something in the spirit of machine translation. Machine translation works because we have this huge aligned corpora of, say, English sentences lined up with French versions of exactly the same sentences. And then these corpora can be used to learn to transform English into French sentences. Now, what if we had a corpus that contained serious headlines lined up with very similar satirical versions of the same headline? Then we could maybe start to learn to transform not English to French, but serious to satirical. All right. So, but how to collect such a corpus? I figured. You might have noticed in the accent, I'm a crowd, so I figured let's crowdsource it. But, is there a bad pun extra price too? All right, so I figured, but before I unleash this onto Mechanical Turk, I tried myself. So I went to New York Times, took a random headline, and I tried to turn it into something satirical. The headline was, "Strife-torn Greece begins to show signs of calm." Now, I really didn't know how to start. I had no clue how to make this funny. So think of Aristotle trying to write a tweet or something like that. And you can imagine that being, so this was a Microsoft research internship and being paid $8,000 per month for trying to make jokes without having any talent for it, you can imagine that my fellow interns quite jealous. So after a while, I felt bad and I figured, well, Bob, let's go back to the roots. You're German. We aren't funny, but we can destroy things. So I figured instead of taking something that's serious and turning it into something satirical, let's do the opposite. Let's take something that's already funny, satirical, and destroy the humor in it to turn it into something serious. We still get a pair of a funny and a serious thing this way. And the result is called Unfun. So Unfun is a human computation game that turns the process of destroying the humor in satirical headlines into a game. As a player, you're given a headline that comes from The Onion. That's funny. And then you're asked to make a minimal change to that headline in order to turn it into something that fools others into believing that it's actually real serious news. So here's an example. You, player A, come to the page, to the site, and then you're given the Onion headline, "Music industry made $18 in 2009. So what could we do to turn this into something serious? Well, we could, for example, insert the word billion. "Music industry made $18 billion in 2009. That sounds quite realistic, right? So in this case, you'd get a large reward because you made a minimal change. You only added one single word. But now, you're smart, so you say, oh, I can easily cheat here. I can just take $18, turn it to $19, minimal change, a lot of points, although the thing is still funny. Doesn't make any difference. Okay, very smart, you evil bastard. And that's why there's a second task called Real or Not, where the headline that you created in the first task is given to someone else, player B, and they're asked to rate on a sliding scale whether they think it's real or not. And the more they think it's real, the more points you get as the creator of this headline. So in a nutshell, you get a lot of points when you make a small change and when you fool others into believing it's real. All right, so let's look at some real examples that come from this game. Who thinks that the headline "Lutheran minister arrested on charges of abusing young children" is real? Real. Sounds sadly real, doesn't it? But actually, it's the unfun version of an Onion headline that reads, "Lutheran minister arrested on charges of boring young children." So here we have effectively collected a pair of something serious and something that's funny, but differs in very little. Next one. Who thinks that Bob Dylan diagnosed with bipolar disorder is real? Okay, well, if you've ever seen a Bob Dylan interview, you would easily be led to believe that Bob Dylan might be bipolar. But actually, it is the unfunded version of the headline, God diagnosed with bipolar disorder. You know, natural disasters, and then all of a sudden, you're lucky. And last one, Schlitz. So Schlitz is a cheap American beer brand. Schlitz returns, drums up nostalgic drinkers. I find that's funny. So I'll vote for all of you here. But because, you know, a beer company drumming up drinkers to their duty of drinking, by the way, you know, for the homeless, for yourself. So that's funny. But it's actually a real headline from the USA Today. So that's kind of a nice side effect of the game. We collect these labels for what people, when are people led to believe that something that's actually funny is serious and vice versa. Okay, so that concludes part 1.1 of my talk, data collection. Now, part 1.2, results. Any questions? No, I don't see any questions, which I think is good. Right? I'm kind of running out of time. Okay. Good. So I'm going to save the part on how we use the data to create onion-level funny headlines for a future time. Maybe ICWSM 2035. In the meantime, if you want to try it yourself, type unfun.me into your favorite browser. You can do HTTP too. Okay, well, that's it. Thank you.